So we're here, the legend, the champ. Chris, how you feeling? Ray, in the house?
Yes.
Where are we going right now? What's going on?
We're going to San Diego. We go to the Icon show. Yes?
Comic-Con.
2023.
I've never been. Have you guys ever been to Comic-Con?
No, first time. I'm excited.
And what's also very exciting, you're going to be on a panel, or you have an appearance with Mike Tyson.
Yes.
Two legends in one place. So tell me about that, being on a show with Mike.
You know, I had some people asking me, Chris, when I was a kid, like 40, or maybe early, my daddy always loved to watch Mike Tyson fights. In Brazil, it was like start like 3 a.m., and I stay awake up to watch with my dad Mike Tyson fights. And for me, it's going to be a pleasure to be with him and be with the legend, you know? Share, maybe going to play video games too today. I'm not good at video games, so.
Ray, are you good at video games?
I can get down on some Tekken, dude. I used to go to the arcade when I was 14, 15, playing out.
Yeah, but I can do really good.
But you know, Mike's known for his power, being explosive, and you have a lot of knockouts. Most MMA fighters don't have a lot of knockouts. Most female fighters or women fighters don't have a lot of knockouts. Chris, what's your secret? You knock a lot of people out.
You know, the beginning when I did my first fight, I even don't know why I have so much anger in my heart to finish the fight and strike and finish everything. But heavy hands, I born like this, you know. I born with heavy hands. And I love finish the fight by strike because I think it's an exciting fight for defense.
No, people love knockouts.
Yes, yes.
So let me ask you guys, we're a few days away. Spencer Crawford.
I'm taking five.
I take a Crawford.
Send him home, bud.
I got Spence. Why do you have Crawford?
I think Crawford's just a better technical boxer. I think he's going to be able to fight on the outside. He'll be able to fight on the inside. I think he's going to get to Spence's body early.
And then Spencer, he's going to be fighting all the time, no?
Yeah, he's been out of the way. Yeah, had the accident with the car.
You guys fought on the same card in Omaha recently.
Yes. We fought and. Nebraska.
Yeah.
At their second boxing fight.
17,000 fans. Yes. So we're going crazy for you, Chris.
Yeah, it was really cool. Really cool opportunity. That was nice. And we have the same dog from Chico Lopez. So it's semi family.
Chico Lopez. Yes. Yeah, great dogs.
Great dog.
Okay, let me ask you this. Canelo or Charlo?
Canelo.
Why?
Too much power.
And I like watching Canelo's fight too. I'm a fan.
All right, here's another one. Nate Diaz or Jake Paul?
I like Jake, but I'm with Nate Diaz because he's came from MMA, and then I'm going to support him to do his best fight. And he can do. He's have a lot of experience, and he's good at his cardio, and the excited people love him.
Ready?
But I know Jake have a lot of power. But I want to support people coming from the Pirates, you know?
I think, I think Jake Paul, but I hope I'm wrong. I hope that Nate Diaz goes out there and proves me wrong. But to do 10 rounds.
I watched him train. He did 12 rounds in 2 days at RGBA. Robert Jim, you guys been to Robert Jim?
Yeah, great gym.
And Nate looks phenomenal sparring. He looked really good, very comfortable.
Nice. You know, I know that he likes to do like cycling, running.
Yes.
So he's having good cardio. Yep. He's having good cardio. So
he's one of the only MMA fighters that goes to the body when they're striking too, right? He's got really good body shots in MMA. So I could see if he's able to get a good work pace early on Jake Paul, if he starts making Jake Paul work, then I can see those body shots paying dividends in the later rounds.
And then, Ray, you have a background in martial arts too, right?
Sure.
How many fights?
25 and 11 in MMA, probably another 10 Muay Thai fights, and I don't know, maybe another 10 mixed rules fights.
That's a lot of fights.
Yeah.
Chris, how many fights do you have?
I think I turned 30. 30 fights? I'm not sure. I've not been counting. But yes, I think it's going to be 29. Maybe 3 Muay Thai fights.
By the way, how did you guys meet?
In Thailand, on vacation.
In Thailand. I went there after my Muay Thai fight. And for training, I have a friend there living there in Phuket. And say, Chris, come here. We can train all day. It's really cool. And then me and Ray shared the same like hotel resort. So I met him there. And yeah, we stayed for school.
That's amazing.
Thailand's amazing. I love good Thailand. I love the food. I love the people. I love training Muay Thai.
Maybe you could do a fight there one day.
Yeah, maybe.
And Manny Pacquiao is in Thailand right now. You know Manny, of course.
Yes.
You met him?
They just announced Manny Pacquiao versus Bulacan.
Oh, this is
cool. All right, break it down. I'm going with Manny.
Exhibition.
Where is it going to be?
We're going to do it in Asia. I don't know where.
This is cool. I would like to be this fight. Very cool.
We'll talk to Manny.
Yes. Yes. I was thinking Manny retired.
He's doing exhibitions, but he might come back for one more.
Okay.
Manny's a really nice person. Chris, do you ever go? You went running with him.
Yes.
How was that?
When I get older, I want to be like a Manny Pacquiao. He's, man, fighting, run around, and man, I run with him, and I was in Hollywood, I think, it's on mountain.
Yeah, Griffith Park. Yep.
Crazy. He running like I think every day maybe 12 or 8 miles. I think I did 8.
55 minutes or something. Yeah.
It's crazy. And then everybody have to run.
Yeah.
Everybody, his team have to run. He's going to spar and training, and everybody's running. It was.
He does 1,500 sit-ups in the morning, 1,500 sit-ups at night.
Yes.
He's in great shape.
Yes, it is.
I also think he's a very nice person. He's very nice.
I like
very
how
generous.
He's helping the community, how he's supporting the people in his country. He's really, really cool. You know, he's no selfish guy. And it's very nice. They say he's really helping people in his country there.
No, Chris, besides doing MMA, which obviously you're a legend, you've won a title in every major sanctioning body. Or not sanctioning body. What do you call it? Promotion? You're also doing boxing now. How do you like doing boxing?
I like it. It's a different sport, but I know it's... I like challenges, you know, I like something different. And then one of my dreams I have, I was fight boxing. I supposed to do my boxing fight beginner before MMA, when I started training boxing. But then it happened, okay, I went to MMA, and I always have a dream. I did jiu-jitsu tournaments, I did wrestling tournaments, I did Muay Thai fights. And then the boxing was the only one I didn't have the opportunity. So for me, it was my dream coming true. And for sure, training only boxing make me better game for MMA. And it's exciting. It's different. You cannot say it's the same in the boxing, same MMA, it's the same in the boxing. It's different. You know, you have to be working, the training, and learn every day.
You were with Jose Benavides.
Yes, I love it.
Tell me about that. David, Jose, everybody. And Virgil Ortiz before that, too.
Yes, I trained you for Virgil for a little bit, too. And I love Virgil. We training every day. He's a lot of patient. It's really cool. And I love his son too. Training really hard. And after he's getting busy. And then Mari Cornejo invited me to go to the Benavides gym. She was there training, Seattle training. And I said, okay, I can go. And I love Jose. I love training for him. He's not try changing my style. Just move it. Getting better, you know, and learning more, but I love training for him. You know, it's my next fight. I would like to do my team boxing for sure. I would like to do it for him. And he's good people, you know, the good family there.
I would love to see his son on Canelo, David Benavides Canelo. That's a big fight, too, right?
Yes, supposed to be the next one then for him. Yes.
Ray, what do you think? David Benavides Canelo.
I think Canelo does not want that fight. I think that, if he wanted that fight would be a big fight. That fight would happen. But Benavides is the next generation coming up, right? And so is Canelo going to give him a chance to pass the torch? I mean, that's kind of what you owe to boxing when you start looking at maybe going out of the next phase is passing that shine on to the next generation, right? I'd like to see it. I mean... People don't give Mayweather the credit of fighting a young Canelo, but you know, let's see Canelo do the same thing for Benavides, right? Be interesting. I think Benavides' power is going to be a bit. His reach is tall. He's really big.
But you know what I found interesting? Chris's two boxing fights. One was 10,000 fans. It's hard to sell tickets in this day and age. It's hard. It's not easy. The other fight, 17,000. So in two fights, it was 27,000 people.
Crazy, right? They actually, when she fought with Terrence Crawford, okay, it was Terrence Crawford's homecoming. But the last time Bud fought in Nebraska was against Jose Benavidez Jr. And they had the big old kickoff at the weigh-in.
Yeah, he swung at him.
And the swing, and Chris fighting on that card with Crawford, who was not fighting an opponent that was really pulling him.
Avanesian, no one knows him, yeah.
The card. They sold almost 1,500 more tickets than the last time Crawford was there and set a state record for the most tickets ever sold to a boxing event in the state of Nebraska.
Wow. And then when Chris headlined in Brazil, it was 10,000. Also, not against like the most famous opponent.
No, that was a tough one, too, because you're talking about a promoter that's only done one other event before, right? So, second-time promoter. They did a lot of hard work on that fight music show. I was really impressed with it overall. And she won a belt there, South of Brazil, regional title, which was crazy because it was just her first fight, but she was fighting a girl that had over 40 professional boxing fights already, right?
We did 8 rounds.
8 rounds and a debut.
Wow, that's amazing.
8 rounds. Yes.
But
it's different about timing too. It's 2 minutes. It's very quick. Like very different than MMA, you know, 5 minutes. This is one thing I really adjust, you know?
The speed, the time. But how'd you get into fighting in the first place in Brazil?
MMA?
Yeah, or anything. Just the first day you walk in the gym.
Yeah.
Why not basketball, volleyball, soccer?
No, I played before. I played handball, I played basketball, I played soccer, I did track and field. I started when I was 12 years old to do sports in school. I have high school, I had a scholarship in Brazil because of sports. Sports really helped me a lot. And then when I was in the college, I was 19 years old. And then one guy saw me play handball, I was very professional. And he told me, I think you can be a great fighter. And I said to him, I don't like fighting. And then he's, I think you can do good. And then he's giving one card from Shooter Box Gym. He said, come, it was Rafael Cordero's coach there. And he said, come to this class. So one day I show up there and I watch the training. The next day I started doing some Muay Thai class. And then I will say, okay, maybe I can do this. I was already strong, I was already athletic, but I didn't know punch. In the beginning, I was like doing like one handball throw, like in the person when I'm fighting. But then I say, okay, I can do it. Because I always compete. So for me, I wasn't getting scared for compete or lose or win. Because I started competing when I was 12 years old. So when I did my first fight, I fight one black belt jiu-jitsu. She was not her first fight, she had a lot of fights. It was my first fight in the professional in 6 months training.
Wow, and you're 19, which is very late to start the combat. Most people start at 4, 5, 3. Here in Southern California, right, people start boxing when they're born.
Yes, yes.
So for you to achieve all this is very, very impressive because you don't really hear people. Deontay Wilder started at 21. That's impressive.
Yes.
You know?
So then I did my first fight and I lost my first fight, I fall, and then I dislocated my elbow.
Wow.
But then I say, you know, I'm born for this. I don't want to do handball anymore. I don't want another sports. I want to do this for relief. And then now I'm going to be 30, 18, almost 19. You're going to be 19 years that makes my arts. You know, I love my job.
And look, I think one of your biggest wins was Gina Carano.
Yeah, that was a big one.
That was a very big one. And then the rest is history.
The fight in Jacaranda was cool because I was fighting in Brazil. I did a lot of fights there, and I stayed like 2 years no opponent.
Wow.
No opponent, not have any girls because at the beginning you don't have a lot of girls. So
no one wanted that smoke, Chris.
Yeah, no one wanted the smoke, and they don't have a lot of girls. And then I stayed 2 years no fighting, just training, just waiting for the opportunity. So then I have the opportunity to fight in America 2008, and I did a couple fights. And then I started to hear about Gina Carano, and then we closed a big fight. Gina Carano's big name, so I knew it was a big opportunity for me. I think, you know, it's lot of, I think one of, I don't have a lot of fights the crowd is no with me, but one that fight was the crowd was no with me. Everybody guess. When you go inside the ring, everybody, ooh. So I say, okay, I came from Brazil, but this is the opportunity I have to get it. So then I got my first title.
I was at an airport watching that fight.
Oh, nice.
And I remember you stopped her on a submission.
Yes. But they stopped the fight. Yeah, it was cool. But, you know, after this fight, a couple years later, I have the opportunity to see Gina Carano at the one Lion Fight event. And then we start talking because when I fight America first with her, I didn't speak any English.
No, that's true.
So funny because and then we start talking about a little bit more. We know each other a little bit more. It was cool. Very cool.
The one fight I would have loved for you to have, and I would have picked you to win this big time, which fight is that, Ray?
Yeah, it's got to be Ronda.
Yep.
Yes,
she Ronda was running. She retired not to fight you. She didn't want to fight you.
Maybe she's coming back. Yeah, here, maybe she's coming back. You know,
she can have that smoke.
What was very cool about the rivalry we have between, like, she was a little dirty. I was already champion when she started talking about me. And talk a lot of stuff for me, but it was nice when people talk for it to make a happen fight, you know. But they never have the fight happen. But people really would like to see this fight.
I would love to see it.
Everybody, it was cool. Even WWE, you know, we can make something happen.
I agree. Yeah, but that would have been big. But she would came up with every excuse under the book not to fight you.
Yeah, they would see her fight against Holly Holm and against Amanda. You know, it was going to be a good fight for me for sure.
You could have kicked her like Holly, you could have punched her like, could have, like, submitted her.
It's going to be tough for her, you know, it's going to be tough. But
yeah, because when she was coming up, she didn't have a lot of competition, too.
Yeah.
So she died. But then when the competition got better, she just quit.
Yeah.
It's just interesting. Right now, how's MMA doing, in your opinion? Good?
I think growing, you know, I think doing great. A lot of girls, a lot of names. Before it was really, when I started, I don't have a lot of girls. This is very cool. Like, you see the kids be training. When you start training, you start like only Muay Thai, only Jiu Jitsu.
Yes.
Now you see the kids like young, 5 years old, 6 years old, they know do everything. They take you down, they choke you, then kick, then punch. So I've been really excited for the next generation, but you know, the sport is really young, only 30 years.
But
I'm really happy how it's growing.
But Chris, Ray, nothing's easy. Mixed martial arts, MMA, Jiu Jitsu, not easy, boxing's not easy, Muay Thai, nothing's easy.
Yeah.
What do you think is the easiest?
What do you mean?
To learn, to pick up, if you never did any of them.
For martial art or to compete or?
Just for martial art.
I don't know. I think the one thing about Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu as a martial art is it is supposed to be designed for the smaller opponent, the weaker opponent, the opponent. And really the goal of Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu is supposed to be able to keep yourself safe without getting injured. Right? But as far as like if I was to compete, I actually think MMA maybe is a little easier to compete in than boxing, because in MMA you can get away with having fundamental areas that are not at a sufficient level because you're able to kind of drive the fight where you want to drive the fight. So you could get a guy that doesn't really know how to throw a jab and doesn't really know how to throw a right hand.
But he'll still pull it off,
He's a really good wrestler. You'll never see him get exposed for not being able to do that. But in boxing, like if you don't have a jab, if you don't know how to fight on the inside, if you don't know how to fight on the outside, like you'll get exposed well before you become a world champion. MMA, you look at a girl like Ronda Rousey, she became the biggest icon in the sport and really only knew how to do half the fight. Like she didn't know how to strike.
Just armbar,
take down and position, but she was able to just kind of like fool people with being able to push the fight where she's the best at, right?
So
point.
Yeah. So, okay, so last thing, Chris, wherever I see you guys, and I see you guys at a lot of events, whether it's boxing events, whether it's just like red carpets, you always get a lot of support from people. What do people tell you when they meet you?
First, they say, "Ah, Chris, you're really nice."
That's true. Everybody does say that.
They think I'm mean because I think they watch my fights. They say, "Ah, maybe she's like this, awake from anger every day." Sometimes before my coffee, I'm not too friendly, but you know, it's really cool all to support my fans. I really like to give you love back for them because a lot of things happened in my career is because my fans support me, help me. So I'm really thankful for them. And I know they are the person, people buy the tickets to go to the fight. They are the people buy the shirt. They support me, follow me. So it's nice if we can give their love back for them.
Absolutely. Just tell people where to follow you and where do they watch all your content?
So you guys can follow me, Chris Cyborg, my Instagram, my Twitter, and you can go to my OnlyFans. I have Chris Cyborg too. It's have nice content. Every week you have a nice thing there. And you can check out more about me. You can go to my website, chriscyborg.com. You're going to find me about everything.
Anything else to add, Ray?
You can buy the new t-shirt for the next fight, alphacatzingano.com.
Yes.
So you have a next fight already, everything?
October.
Wow, okay, coming up.
Catzingano, number one contender. Girl beat Amanda Nunez, Misha Tate.
Wow.
Yeah.
That's a big one.
That's an exclusive.
Okay, guys, so there you have it. Cyber back in the ring in October. Don't miss it. Fireworks. Any idea where the fight takes place? Location?
Still negotiate with a couple of venues, but hopefully in the next 2 weeks we'll have something to announce.
All right, so make sure you go to Chris Cyborg on Twitter and Instagram and OnlyFans and get all the info. Stay tuned. Elisek back reporting.